Hello and welcome to Doubles and Trebles. I'm back on a solo mission for an anti-post update on the Epsom Derby. Thanks to everyone that's watched our big anti-post preview on the Derby. It's been our best performing video of the year. Thanks for watching. There's a link in the description below if you've not already seen that. And if you have watched our Derby content, why not nip over and watch our Oaks content as well? That needs a little bit of love in the viewing figures. Just a short video really here to update on the market as the runners and riders are starting to take shape. There's just 9 days to go before the most important race in the British racing calendar, probably the most important race in the world of flat racing. Desert Crown, 9-4, clear favourite now. With Stone Age on the drift, he's around 100 to 30 best prices, a bigger price on the exchange as well. Stone Age is on the drift. I don't see the reason for that. I did predict that Desert Crown would be going off favourite. He was favourite a couple of weeks ago already when we spoke. So Michael Stout commenting that Desert Crown doesn't actually need to improve, was his quote, much from the Derby to win the Derby following his Dante performance. Strong words really there from Sir Michael Stout. This is a horse that's only had two starts. His second start was in the Dante. It was only his first start of this season in the Dante, having, you know, he's not been seen between November and May. And he won the Dante really impressively. We covered that on the last video. You can pick holes in the form behind, but there were some good yardsticks. Royal Patronage, he was in second, and he's absolutely slammed him virtually on the bridle. Desert Crown, just a performance with all sorts of potential and excitement going to for his future, and he's the rightful Derby favourite, to be fair. Strong comments from Sir Michael Stout, but also strong comments in our comments from Bobby Knox, who has warned us against listening or taking note of such comments like Sir Michael Stout has made in regards to Desert Crown. So yeah, interesting there. But also shout out to Bob Diaz in the comments. He's all over Desert Crown. He thinks he's the winner, and there'll be plenty of people agreeing with you, Bob. Come Epsom next Saturday. I mean, as I previously said, Stone Age has got a very different profile to Desert Crown. Desert Crown's only had two starts. I think Stone Age had five starts last year without winning. He's won two starts already this year. But Stone Age has done absolutely nothing wrong this year for me. And yeah, we've got Tom Leach in the comments. He's on Stone Age at 20-1. I wish I could be on at that price, Tom, but I might be joining you in backing Stone Age if the drift continues. I just think that the gap between Desert Crown and Stone Age at the top of the market might be coming a little bit too big, as the groundswell of support that I alluded to on our last video for Sir Michael Stout and the English runner, if you like, and the unexposed, exciting horse. But I mean, you know, there's plenty of excitement to come from Stone Age. He's won two races this year by 9 lengths and 5.5 lengths, and he's trained by Aidan O'Brien, and he's likely to be really ridden by Ryan Moore. I mean, you know, what more do you need, really? So, as has become a theme on the Derby analysis that I've done so far, I've certainly not nailed my colours to any horse or any bet so far. Unlike the Oaks, where I really do fancy one individual, that will still be the conclusion at the end of this video. So don't be surprised if you get to the end of the video and I'm still sitting on the fence. Next in the market is a horse that isn't even entered in the race as we speak. Nation's Pride is 8-1 best price. He's trained by Charlie Appleby. The signs are Godolphin will probably pay for him to be supplemented on Monday. I think that's the 1st of June. That's the supplementary stage. I think it's going to cost him in the region of 50 grand, maybe even more, because he's not currently entered in the race, but he can be. He wasn't covered on our initial video because I wasn't sure if he was going to run Nation's Pride, but he won a Newmarket listed race impressively at the end of April by over 7 lengths. That was on his only UK start this year. He had one start in Maidan in February, which is an unusual Derby type to be running in Maidan over the winter and early in the year, and then still turning up in classics. But you know, it's something that Godolphin have tried and tested over the years, going over to Maidan. Saeed Bin Saroor does it more than Charlie Appleby, you would probably say. So that's something to take note of. Nation's Pride drifted in the market for that listed race at Newbury on the day. As Superstar, trained by Roger Veery, was the talking horse. He went off favourite. But in the end, there was 9 lengths between the two market leaders. Superstar was absolutely smashed by Nation's Pride on the day, and there would have been a few fingers burnt in the betting. Hu Yamal was second. Superstar was third. Hu Yamal was second, and he came into the race rated 105, and he was blitzed 7 lengths by Nation's Pride. So it's tasty form. I would have thought that Nation's Pride might have ran between the end of April at Newmarket and the start of June at Epsom. That's clearly not the plan anymore. He's obviously going pretty well at home. Charlie Appleby has spoke up about his three contenders this week. I'm going to come on to the other two of them. But yeah, Nation's Pride could well go off the Godolphin number one. He's 1-4 on the bounce now. There's a lot to like about him, but it's a big step up from listed level, beating, you know, the Roger Varian's horse that has since disappointed again. He's been beaten again, Superstar, since then. And there's a bit of a gap in the market and in the form book between Nation's Pride and the top two in the market that we've already covered. Sticking with the Godolphin theme, Walk of Stars, who's 20-1 in the region at the moment, and the Harney, who's 25-1. They both went for a spin at what used to be called Breakfast with the Stars at Epsom. It's now just a glorified public workout morning. So they get to go for a spin round Epsom. Nahani's already had a spin round Epsom in an actual race and won the what's officially called the Epsom Derby Trial over 10 furlongs. That was earlier in April. The form of that's been backed up, to be honest. United Nations, who was behind that day, I think he was 4-4 fifth for Aidan O'Brien at Epsom, has gone on to win the Lingfield Derby Trial. So that's decent form. Mighty Ulysses was in that race, was one of the favourites for that race, the Epsom Derby Trial. He's since gone back and won a handicap, was close in a Haydock handicap last weekend. They're over shorter trips. Yeah, I think Nahani is certain to stay. Kizastar in the comments fancies him. He's on at 25-1. Yeah, he's certainly got a chance. He's certainly one to stay, Nahani. And he's got the experience around Epsom. Is his form quite good enough? I don't know. He's got an official rating of 93. His RPR in winning the Epsom Blue Ribbon was 100. You know, it's not quite good enough, if you ask me, when you look towards Desert Crown, who got a rating of 120 in the Dante. He's going to have to take a big step forward. He could well do. Another Godolphin contender, Walk of Stars. He went for a spin round Epsom as well. A month ago, I was all over Walk of Stars. I really liked him, but I was disappointed with him at Lingfield, where he was second behind United Nations, as I've mentioned. The form of Walk of Stars novice race, first time up this year at Newbury, has been knocked. It looked decent at the time. It was only a free runner event, but it looked impressive visually. It's been knocked. The horse he beat that day, Half It, has been out and has went off odds on in a race at France and got walloped, unfortunately. So yeah, there's question marks over his form, but I did like him after Newbury. But since then, form's been knocked and he's been beat at Lingfield. A lot went wrong for Walker Stars at Lingfield. He wasted a lot of energy early doors. He was pulling a bit free. Raced a bit wide. I think there was only four runners at Lingfield. They spread across the track a little bit. Wasn't the ideal setup for Walk of Stars. Charlie Appleby, the trainer, thinks that Walk of Stars did well to finish as close as second, given his early exertions of that energy. He's a contender if showing his best, but he's got plenty of questions to answer, as I've already posed. The jockey bookings on these three Godolphin runners, Nation's Pride, Walk of Stars, Nahani, is going to be very interesting. William Buick's number one, James Doyle's number two, Adam Kirby's number three. We saw last year Adam Kirby was number three. He was on a 50-1 shot in the morning. It went off a lot shorter, a day out and one. So, you know, as always, horses are still improving at this time of the year. And for these big stables that have got multiple runners, don't be put off by the jockey bookings or the price. Westover, another contender, also had a spin round Epsom on Monday, and Ralph Beckett, he's got his horses about 20-1. Won the Sandown Classic Trial, mentioned him on my previous video. He's unsure to stay the trip, but he showed plenty of promise in winning that Sandown Classic Trial. He did have to knuckle down and won quite well over a couple of promising horses in behind, Cash being one of them. Aidon, the final horse that I'm going to mention, just to update on, really, yeah. Roger Varian's poured cold water on backing him to punters. He's gave a warning to punters because Aidon, who finished fourth in the 2,000 guineas at Newmarket and before that had won the Fielden Stakes as the outsider of the field, reasonably impressive. He went for a spin round Epsom as well the other day, but Roger Varian has said he's 50-50 of whether Aidon will participate at Epsom or stay over 10 furlongs, or prefer 10 furlongs for the French Derby. He's 25-1 in the market at the moment. His question marks over participation are factored into his price. He could well be the springer in the market, Aidon. If he is confirmed for Epsom, I could well see him going off at least half the 25-1 he currently is now, if declared for Epsom. Where would my money go? I've still not committed to a horse or a bet in the Derby. I've still not had a bet. We only talk about bets on here or advise bets on here that we are happy to back up ourselves. Tranquil Lady in the Oaks being an example of that. I have backed her and I would be happy to back her again. But yeah, where would my money be going for the Derby? 9 days to go. I'm still undecided. Stone Age, if he keeps drifting, I mean, he's over 4-1 on the exchange at the minute. I think that's too big. Will that be the case on the day? I do not know. If it is, I'll certainly be interested. The support for Desert Crown continues. I don't know. I've got this connection to Walk of Stars, and I don't know why. I keep coming back to him. I loved him at Newbury visually, but then he's disappointed in terms of the form of that race and at Lingfield. I've already mentioned that in this video, but I just keep coming back to him. It's going to be really interesting what the Godolphin jockey bookings are. I might end up back in Walker Stars each way on the day, but I've certainly not committed, and there'll be plenty of other videos and updates as we go along, and I will, as always, confirm the bets in full that me and Pieman are advising. So Pieman will be back soon. Hopefully he gets his internet fixed. The big race is only a few days away now, so thanks for tuning in, and keep the comments coming. Good luck. Cheers.